I'm gonna get really, really close to my canvas here. I'm gonna start doing. Hey guys, welcome to Paint for Fun. So today we are going to be painting a fun little pineapple for the summer months. It's pretty simple. I'm only gonna be using a flat medium round brush for this and a small round pointed brush. I'm also going to be using four colors only. So I have blue, red, yellow, and white. If you're working bigger, you could use a bigger flat brush as well just to cover the surface. But since I'm working small, I'm only gonna be using the medium flat brush. So we're gonna get started. It's pretty simple. I'm gonna just wet my brush to begin with the medium flat brush. We're gonna start. Take some yellow paint. We're just gonna trace or draw out the shape of the pineapple. So I'm working pretty small here. I'm not gonna do a huge pineapple, but I'm kind of making this oval shape to begin. So you can just kind of flatten the top a little bit. It's not gonna be a perfect oval. So the top's gonna be a little bit flatter. The sides are gonna curve down like this. On each side, you could do the same thing. Just curve down slightly. You can always adjust your shape afterwards. So try to start small. And if you wanna adjust it, you can. So I'm gonna round it out like that, and base is gonna be flat as well. And there you have it. So that's gonna be the outline of the pineapple. I'm just gonna start by filling this in with yellow paint. I'm gonna add a little bit of shadow and highlights to this afterwards. For now, just fill this all in. Like so, and we're gonna start adding a little bit of detail to this now. So we're gonna start by just adding a bit of a darker bottom, just to create a little bit of a shadow. So I'm gonna take some red paint, not too much, like very, very little red paint. Take some yellow as well. And I don't want a lot of paint on my brush at all. So I'm kind of getting rid of the excess paint on my plate here. Just want a tiny, tiny bit. And I'm just gonna start like very lightly dabbing along the edges, kind of give it a bit of an outline. You can even dab it all the way up if you'd like. And as you get lower, I'm gonna start kind of dabbing inside the pineapple as well. Okay, so this is just one layer we're gonna do. We're gonna do a few others as well with a little bit of a deeper red. So again, I'm just dabbing along the outline here. And working my way down. Also just gonna give it a bit of a texture because the surface of the pineapple is pretty rough and scaly. Okay, so I'm gonna kind of fade that out into the yellow up here. If you feel like you went a little bit too intense, you can always go back and retouch it up with some yellow and white paint, which I'll do a little bit later. So I'm gonna go back and take a little more of that red color. I wanna give it a bit of a pop. So I'm gonna start adding a little bit of a darker red down here. So just be really random when you're dabbing. Keep it pretty inconsistent so it doesn't look super perfect. And it'll give it a little bit more of a natural feel if you keep it very random. So I'm gonna stop here for now. What I'm gonna do is rinse out my brush. We're gonna go a little bit lighter to kind of tone down the intensity of it. So I'm gonna take a bit of yellow, tiny, tiny bit of white. Again, I don't have a lot of paint on my brush. I never use a lot of paint. And I'm gonna start dabbing here at the top. It's gonna kind of lighten and soften it a little bit. So right where the colors meet with the yellow, that like harsh edge, I'm just gonna kind of tone it down a little bit with this lighter yellow. So it doesn't seem as intense. I'm gonna rinse out my brush again because once you work your way down, the brush is gonna get a little bit dirty with that darker orange or red color. And if you go back up into the yellow, you're gonna stain the yellow as well. So you kind of wanna avoid that. So always rinse out your brush if you feel like going a little bit higher up into that lighter yellow color so you don't dirty it. So I'm gonna play along the edges here a little more. Okay, so I'm gonna stop there for now, re-rinse my brush. I'm gonna start adding all of these little lines on the pineapple to give it some detail. So I'm gonna use my small brush for this. I'm gonna start by using a sort of darker orange color. So I'm gonna wet my brush a little bit, take some of that red paint, tiny bit of yellow, not too much. And again, if it's too intense, we'll just go over it afterwards. So for the pineapple, the lines on it, it's almost like a hexagon shape. Now, you don't have to do a perfect hexagon for every tiny thing. They could start rounding out a little bit more at the top, but in some areas, you could start making these little hexagon shapes and they'll all pretty much attach together. So you can fill it in. Kind of, if you don't feel like doing hexagon shapes, you can even just do like little rounded shapes if you want. Again, they don't also have to be exactly the same size. You could do some that are a little bit like smaller at the top, filling it in at the bottom, and then maybe I'll switch color towards the top and go for a little bit more of a lighter yellow green tone, just because the top part is fairly light. So because I'm playing in the orange and red section, I want to keep it kind of in that family of color. Okay, so I'm going to start rinsing it out and I'm going to go a little bit lighter. So I'm going to add a little more yellow, maybe a bit of white. That's not that noticeable. So I'm going to add a bit more yellow, red to it. Okay, so I want to still keep it fairly subtle, not too intense. Okay, so I'm going to start kind of rounding out the shapes a little bit. Here at the top. And keep going. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to kind of go with a bit of a greenish tone as well. So, rinse out the brush. I'm gonna take a tiny bit of blue, not a lot at all. Mix it with some yellow. And I'm gonna do a little bit of white. I might pick up a little bit of that orange color as well. Not very much. I'm just gonna take a tiny bit because I kind of want to dirty it a little bit to give it a greenish orange tone. Okay, so this might be a little bit dark, it's not so bad, but if it is a little too dark, I'll show you how to tone it down a little bit later once we're done with all these shapes. Towards the top also, you could start making your little shapes smaller. So it's almost like you're drawing fish scales. I'm gonna also mix some other colors as well because I don't want it to only be green. I'm gonna go back with some orange. And you can also just play around with it and like add some little bits of orange in there. I'm gonna mix a little more paint. Some areas you could keep more green. Like the more variety you have in color, the nicer it's gonna look. And again, if it is a little too intense, your color will soften it a little bit later. And you could also just dab in some of that green tone in the pineapple as well, just to give it a little more of a unripened look. So I'm gonna stop there. You can go back to the medium brush now. I'm gonna give it just a tiny bit of a drying break for now, and then we're gonna add a bit of highlights and outline it a little bit nicer. I'm gonna add some dots in the middle. For now, what you can do is, we can do the bottom part here if we'd like. So it's kind of like a wash what I'm doing, and almost like a tiny bit of a shadow. So I'm taking some blue paint here, some white, mix it together. You can do any color you want for the shadow. I'm just keeping it kind of abstract, and I'm very loosely doing these horizontal lines. Keep it messy. I want it to be really random. And from there, I'm gonna go back, rinse my brush. I'm gonna go with a bit of a purple tone. So I'm gonna take some red, add it to the blue. Get a bit of white in there, not too dark. And right at the bottom here, gonna add a few more bits of color. And I'm gonna stop there. You could rinse out your brush. So let's add a few details, a few more details to the pineapple. So if you want to tone down some areas, if you feel like it's too intense, you could do a light yellow wash over it. So just take a little bit of yellow paint, not a lot at all, and just kind of dab over some areas just to kind of soften the tone. If you want to pick up some white, mix it in there, you could do that as well. Keep in mind the white will make it more opaque. So if you feel like you have some harsh lines that you do want to tone down, add a bit of white because it's going to make the paint a little more opaque and you're going to hide the intensity of it. If you just use yellow, yellow paint usually is pretty transparent, depending also the quality of paint you're using. A higher quality will be less transparent for sure, but it always helps to mix it with a tiny bit of white if you're looking to get rid of some intense lines underneath or you want more coverage. I'm gonna switch to my little brush again, and we're gonna kind of outline it because it's a little bit messy on the side here. So I'm gonna go back with some red, a bit of yellow. I'm gonna also dirty it a little bit. So I'm gonna take some of that green that I had, not too much, just a tiny bit. Make the red-orange color a little less intense. And right along the side here, I'm gonna start kind of outlining it. You don't have to make the line perfectly curved. I'm kind of making it a bit wavy to kind of add that texture that the pineapple has. Okay, same thing on the other side. If you want to touch up some of the lines on the inside, you can. Now is the time to do that. So I feel like this side here is a little bit too intense, so I'm going to tone down that outline here with just a bit of that yellow color. Not too much, but very slightly. Make it a little bit thinner. Okay, so now we're gonna add some highlights to this. So I'm gonna take just a bit of white on my little brush, and just in certain areas here, right at the top, you can start giving it just a tiny bit of a highlight. Not in every tiny section, every shape that you made, just some of them. Add a bit of yellow to that for the bottom section so it's not as intense. So So I'm just highlighting the top of some of the shapes. And it's gonna give it a little more of a 3D effect. I like to keep it a little bit messy too, just to give it a more natural feel. So I'm kind of like dabbing over, even if you dab over some of the lines. So it'll make some of the lines, like some of them will be a little more intense, some will be a little bit faded out because I'm dabbing that white or highlight over it. So it'll give it a more natural appearance. Okay, so I'm gonna stop there. What we're gonna do next is add a couple little dots in the middle. So you can do this in any of the colors. So I'm gonna use a variety of different colors. I'm gonna go in with some of that red and yellow that we made earlier. If you have no more paint, you can mix some more. You can even add a bit of green to kind of dirty it slightly. And again, not in every single shape, but just in some of them, you can kind of do, it's almost like an inverted V shape. Because it's so small, it's kind of hard to tell, but very gently. And add a bit of water to that. And as you go up, you can also make them a little bit less intense. So you can lighten the color. You can take a bit of a green tone if you want as well, which I might do. So very, very gently, not a lot of pressure on your brush. So I might do some with that green tone. Right up here, just a couple. Next step is the leaves. So for the leaves, I'm gonna use my medium brush just to kind of bring out the shape, and then you can do some of the highlights with it with the small brush as well. We'll alternate between the two. So what I'm gonna do is mix some green tone. I'm gonna start with a dark green. So take some blue, use another section of your plate, a bit of yellow. So I wanna keep it fairly dark. What I do also when I make greens for foliage or plants, if I just mix blue and yellow as is, it's pretty intense, the color, okay? I wanna kind of tone it down. So I dirty it with a bit of red. Don't add too much red to it. Just a tiny bit, and it's kind of bring down the intensity of the color, make it a little more natural looking. So that's pretty dark. I'm gonna start there. So the leaves at the bottom are gonna be smaller, and then they're gonna get a little bit bigger at the top. So you can start with your, if you wanna use your small brush for this, mine's pretty big as well. So might switch if it doesn't work very well. Yeah, let's go with the small brush for the bottom part because I'm working tiny. So I'm gonna pick up a little bit of that dark green paint and start doing these little, almost like triangular shapes. You can curve them. We're gonna fill that all in afterwards. So they're gonna start curving out and upwards. Okay, as you go up, they're gonna start getting longer and longer. So I'm just curving these little triangular shapes here. I think now I could switch to my medium brush. And obviously the top ones are gonna be pretty big. Okay, so you can fill in the rest of it here with this green color. I'm gonna add a bit of highlights to it afterwards so it looks like there's other leaves in front. Right now it just looks pretty flat. All right, so what I'm gonna start doing is adding a bit of highlights. So what I'm gonna do is take some white, add it in a little bit of that green color, still keep some of the darker bit. So I have one section that has the dark green and I have another section that has a lighter green because I added some white in there. If you feel like the color's too dirty, you could add a bit more yellow as well to it and see how that goes. I'm just gonna add a tiny bit of yellow. Now what I'm gonna do is start adding more highlights, which is gonna give it the illusion that there's other leaves as well. So I'm gonna start adding highlights here, just curving my lines. And you could add other shapes on the inside. You could retrace the darker shadows areas afterwards. So I'm gonna add more of these little shapes here on the inside to make it look like there's other leaves as well. Okay, so just doing that alone already gave it a little bit more dimension. And you could go in a little bit further. Okay, so what I'm also gonna do is go back and you could add a bit lighter and a bit darker. So let's start with the light. So I'm gonna still add a bit more white to it. I'm not even gonna clean my brush. I'm just using my dirty brush and taking a tiny bit of white. So it's gonna become like a lighter green. And really in just a couple of little areas, we're gonna give it a bit more of a highlight. So even if it's too intense at first, don't worry about it. We're gonna tone it down. And for the shadows, we're gonna go back to that dark green that we had initially used, and we can kind of outline some of the leaves so they're a little more intense. So I'm just gonna add a couple of darker areas here. So you really start to define the leaves a little bit more. So keep in mind, all the leaves in the background will be slightly darker. Okay, so I'm gonna leave that as is. So the last few steps are basically some spatter effect. If you feel like you want to add more shadow to your pineapple, which I might do right here actually, before we continue with the spatter effect, I feel like it's a little bit light. So I'm gonna go back with, gonna rinse my brush off first. I go with a bit more of an orange tone, just a tiny bit. Maybe like right around here where the pineapple top is, to give it a bit more of a shadow. Back with some of that orange, just a little bit, and kind of touch up the top here. So now's the time if you feel like you want to add a little bit, if it's too intense, you can add a bit of a lighter tone to tone it down a bit, but now's the time to play around with it, to adjust till you're happy. Okay, so for the last step, we're gonna do a bit of a spatter effect all around. So I'm gonna take my medium brush for this. We're only gonna use two colors. So we're gonna use a purple tone, so the same colors as the shadow here. I'm gonna use that light blue. So if you have leftover light blue, use it. If you ran out, you could just mix some blue and white together. Now add a few drops of water to that paint so it's really liquidy. I'm gonna get really, really close to my canvas here. I'm gonna start doing this spatter effect. Even if it goes over your pineapple, it's all good. It's kind of abstract. That's the look I'm going for. I want it to be colorful, I want it to be fun. And you can do as much as you want. If you want to skip this step, you could skip this step as well. That spatter is not your thing. Okay, so I'm gonna stop there and do the same thing with a purple tone. So I'm gonna take some red and blue, a tiny bit of blue, not too much. I'm gonna add some white to that. Add some drops of water so it becomes nice and liquidy. And same thing, get right in there and start adding some purple. All right, so that's it. There you have a fun little pineapple for the summer. Hope you like this tutorial. If you try it out, let me know how it goes. Post your results. If you have any suggestions on other paintings that you'd like me to see, that you'd like me to try, and you can follow along with me, let me know in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and please like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.